In a conversation with a group of friends a few days back, one person asked, why do lawyers like to embellish their statements and presentations with Latin phrases? I am confident that this question has ever popped up in your mind as well. Today, we'll be discussing legal maxims. Hi, my name is Nao Fabia Mensah. Welcome to Fun Facts Friday on Legal Moments. What are legal maxims and why are they usually quoted in Latin? They are established principles or propositions of the law. They originated in the medieval era from states that had adopted Latin as their legal language. These propositions by themselves are not law. However, they guide the court in the application of the law in a fair and just manner. Now, we'll be looking at a few of these Latin phrases and how the law applies them. The first one is ab initio. Ab initio simply means from the very beginning. This phrase is usually used in relation to contracts or agreements. So that if we say that an agreement or a contract is void ab initio, it simply means that contract is void or was void from the very beginning. In the eyes of the law, it never existed. For example, in Ghana, ordinance marriages are deemed to be monogamous by nature, such that any marriage subsequent to this one will be deemed to be void ab initio. Let me break this down further. A peer is married to a peer under the ordinance. Remember, ordinance marriages are monogamous by nature. However, 3 years down the line, a peer gets married to Mansa. No matter the nature or form of that marriage, within the eyes of the Ghanaian law, it will be deemed void ab initio, meaning it was never caused into being. The next Latin phrase we'll be looking at is actus dei nemini injuriam, which means no man shall be responsible for the acts of God. So what is an act of God? It is a situation of uncontrollable natural forces in operation. For example, floods, hurricanes, or a worldwide pandemic as we have it today. If by reason of the occurrence of any of these acts of God, a party to an agreement is unable to fulfill his part at the scheduled time, he shall not be held responsible because he did not have control over the situation. In recent times, the worldwide pandemic, coronavirus, caused a lot of governments to take very harsh decisions, which included a total lockdown of their international borders. So, if by reason of this lockdown, a party to an agreement is unable to carry through with his part of that agreement, he should not be held responsible or liable for the non-performance. The next maxim we'll be looking at is actus non facit reum nisi mensit rea. This simply means that the intent and act must both be present to form a crime. It is said that a person shall be guilty for the crime that he commits. However, this statement is not absolute, and that is what is provided for by the aforementioned legal maxim. For a person to be held criminally liable, he or she must have committed an act forbidden by law, and this act must be accompanied by a blameworthy mind. This is why a person suffering from a mental disorder cannot be said to have committed a crime. The last but not least legal maxim that we'll be looking at is audi aut eram partem, which simply means hear the other side. It is said that to every story, there are two sides. This maxim highlights the fact that when a matter is brought before a court, for it to be properly adjudicated or fairly adjudicated, both parties must be heard. This is why when you sue someone, the rules of court require that You serve them personally with the court process or through any other lawful means that the court may direct. This ensures that the person that you have sued is put on notice. This notice also serves as an invitation to them to appear in court to have their side of the story heard. There are many of these Latin legal maxims. However, we cannot discuss all of them on today's episode. So let's get interactive in the comment section. Share with me the ones that you know of and let's have a conversation about them. Kindly subscribe to the channel if you haven't done that already. Turn on your notification button so that anytime we upload a video, you'll be the first to know. Thank you and see you in our next episode.